disorders have always been prominent in clinical genetic practice, and this has increased with the advent of molecular approaches. Next-generation sequencing had made it possible to examine a large number of possible diseases in a single reaction, which was previously impossible. This has resulted in rapid identification of genes involved in Mendelian disorders, thus a more precise diagnosis of many neurological disorders is now possible. And genetic testing can be considered earlier in diagnostic procedure. Genetic neurological disorders, GNDs. There is an estimate of over 30 million people affected from neurological disorders in India. That excludes neuroinfections and traumatic injuries. Neurological disorders are often chronic, progressive, and their phenotypes are genetically very heterogeneous. The four means to guide clinical classifications in GNDs are: first, the earliest clinical signs are referred to neuroanatomic region or pathology specific to that disease. Second, the age of onset for the clinical signs and symptoms. The earlier age of onset directly correlates with the severity of the disorder. Third, mode of inheritance. Fourth, involvement of extra organs. Other extra neural signs and symptoms such as presence of specific signs involving eye, skin, connective tissue, or any other visceral organs. If we categorize GNDs, that is genetically neurological disorders, there are mainly 7 to 8 major categories: epilepsies, movement disorders, neuromuscular disorders, neurometabolic disorders, neurodegenerative disorders, neurocutaneous, and mitochondrial disorders. I'll be describing them one by one. Epilepsy, around 6 to 8 million people are estimated with epilepsy in India, with very high prevalence, most prevalent at either end of the age spectrum, either manifesting at a very early age or at a late onset. Can be syndromic, can be non-syndromic. Examples include infantile seizures, Lennox-Gastaut syndrome. Neuro movement disorders. These are characterized by excess or a paucity of movement that is not connected to weakness, paralysis, or spasticity of muscles. Affect the speed, fluency, quality, and ease of movements. Often associated with poor coordination of hand, speech, eye movement. Clinical presentation is very complex, often variable, and sometimes even bizarre. Commonest examples are spinocerebral ataxia, Tourette, juvenile Parkinson. Neuromuscular disorders, disorders that affect the peripheral nervous system. Principal effect is on the ability to perform voluntary movements. Include some of the most devastating disorders afflicting mankind, like LGMDs, limb girdle muscular dystrophy, spinal cerebellar atrophy, Duchenne, Baker's. Neurometabolic disorders. Neurological manifestations are prominent signs and symptoms of inborn error of metabolism, IEMs. These are characterized by lack or dysfunction of an enzyme or vitamin necessary for a specific chemical reaction in the body. Mostly are present in newborns and infants. Examples include MSUDs, lysosomal storage disorders, MCL, Krebs, MPS, Gaucher. Neurodegenerative disorder involves the progressive loss of structure or function of neurons, including death of neurons. Can be serious or life-threatening, and most of them have no cure. Examples include adrenoleukodystrophy, dystrophy, Canavan. Neurocutaneous disorders. These neurological disorders have cutaneous manifestation. These are lifelong conditions and can cause tumors to grow inside brain, spinal cord, organs, skin, skeletal bones. Commonest examples are TSCs, tuberous sclerosis, neurofibromatosis. Neuromitochondrial disorders. These are clinically very heterogeneous group of disorders arising due to mutations either in mitochondrial DNA or the nuclear DNA for mitochondrial components. Difficult to diagnose because it affects each individual differently. Symptoms can include seizures, stroke, severe developmental delay, inability to walk, talk, see, digest food, combined with a host of other complications. Commonest examples are Miller's, Murph, Lawn. Our neurogenetic disorders involves a broad range of pre-designed genetic mutation panels which have been developed in depth disease understanding of the genetic disorder, incorporating the latest research in that particular domain. New updated technologies, helpful customer surveys, clear result interpretation, along with counseling sessions with our genetic counselors, makes us equipped to provide you the best available support for your patients, families with inherited metabolic disorders. Some NGS-based targeted panels in neurogenetics involve next-gen-seq adrenoleukodystrophy, next-gen-seq Alexander disease, alkaptonuria, Alzheimer disease, amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, ataxia-telangiectasia, Charcot-Marie-Tooth disease and sensory neuropathies, comprehensive epilepsy, dementia, Dravet syndrome and early infantile epileptic encephalopathy, dystonia and many others. Second category, dynamic mutations. These involve fragment analysis for repeat expansion analysis of microsatellites like di, tri, tetranucleotide repeats. Expansion of existing polymorphic DNA repeats sequenced beyond the copy number threshold. These are the second abundant genetic variation in human genome. Many results in neurodegeneration. Severity of many diseases increases with the number of repeats. Expansion results in abnormal protein leading to disease. Number of repeats may expand in subsequent generation. We often call it anticipation. Our neurogenetic repeat expansion and hotspot tests are spinocerebral ataxia range, myotonic dystrophy, both the type 1 and type 2, SMBA, spinobulbular muscular atrophy, DRPLA, FXTS, fragile X tremors and ataxia syndromes and many more. Who should be tested? First, the patient suspected to be suffering from the disease, and second, family member of a patient for a carrier screening. We need around 5 to 10 ml of EDTA blood. We extract DNA, sequence the DNA using NGS-based technique, analyze it using bioinformatics softwares and report. Relevant clinical information, including all the clinical presentations, MRI findings, and symptoms in the TRF should be there. TRF stands for test requisition form. Withholding any clinical or medical information, including the patient's family history or consanguinity, may impact the results in the interpretation. We are offering better test and price as per clinician's requirement. High coverage across the genes. Processing is in India for a faster and accurate reporting. Test performance on high quality NGS-based Illumina platforms. Results are reported based on ACMG guidelines. Dr. Lal Path Labs provides an end-to-end integrated solution to clinical genomics in India and is highly focused on Indian population. Thank you.